Pinagmulan The Journey Home is brought to you by Cathay Pacific, Airline of the Year 2006. Zap Snacks, super zarap ang zap. And Goldilocks, how thoughtful, how Pinoy. Closed captioning for this program is brought to you by Andok's Lechon Manok, the Filipino chicken. The road of life is fraught with peril, which is just another way of saying life is never easy. No matter where you are, the challenges of life will follow, and it might take years of perseverance to finally see them through. Some throw in the towel, others roll with the punches until they finally come out the victors. And sometimes that journey just might lead you back to where it all started. Home is where it all starts. This is the program that brings Pinoys in the United States back to the Philippines to rediscover their roots and be reunited with their loved ones. I'm your host, Mike Ingona. Welcome to Pinagmulan, The Journey Home.
Posible kayang labanan ang agos ng paghamon. Magwal at matapaman, sabay tayong aahon. Posible kayang mabura alinlangan sa sarili. Sa loob makikita, taglay mo ang dugong bayani.
Several ways of gaining wisdom by reading, practicing, doing, or actually living through the experience. At 62 years old, Bernie Fernandez is wise to the ways of the world, but he had to learn his lesson the hard way. He's a former boxer from Masbate, and his story packs a punch. This is Bernie's journey back home, back to his Pinagmulan. Bernie's story begins in America's favorite vacation destination. And it's not by mere stroke of luck that this city has become just that. From gambling to shows, shopping, restaurants, this city has something for everyone. Welcome to the entertainment capital of the United States, Las Vegas, Nevada.
With all the glitz and glamour that is associated with the legendary strip, there's only one thing for sure about the look of Las Vegas, and that is nothing's for sure. It seems like no matter how prestigious a hotel or casino may be, no one is safe from implosion, replacement, or renovation. The face of Vegas is a changing facade that becomes whatever its visitors or migrants want it to be. Thousands move to Vegas yearly, and many of our very own Capamilia have comfortably settled in this oasis in the desert, including Bernie and his family.
So, Bernie, this is your cab. We're in your town. How long have you been doing this for?
4 years and 4 months.
How do you know that it's been 4 years and 4 months? What do you even...
I count it.
What's the biggest tip that you ever got?
$400.
No way.
Yes, way.
When was that?
This vice president of Caltex gasoline.
Yeah.
And he just asked me, where are you from? And I tell him I'm from the Philippines. He was in the Philippines for a long time. He tells me, you like watch boxing? I said, oh, no, I cannot watch boxing. I got to work. I got to make money. My wife will kill me if I don't make money.
You didn't tell him you were a former boxer, did you?
I told him. I told him that I was a boxer. That's why the reason he also gave me a ticket. I mean, money for my ticket.
That's great. Bernie and his wife, Elena, have been married for 37 years. They're the proud grandparents to 11 grandchildren by their three sons, Johnny,
Andre, and Bernie Jr. The Fernandez household has become an entertainment center because all three sons have turned out to be professional performers. Johnny's a singer who actually launched an album in the Philippines back in the 80s and was on tour with the Broadway musical Miss Saigon.
This is the moment. They're more the odds. This day or never, I'll sit forever with the gods. When I look back, I will always recall, moment for moment, this was the moment of them all.
Andre has all the right moves as the chief choreographer and star dancer of Stomp here in Las Vegas. And Bernie Jr. always gets the last laugh as the budding stand-up comedian.
I'll just bring it back to Hawaii. It's a little, just reminisce, just think waterfalls, palm trees, blue skies, beautiful women, and a sexy body like mine. And I'll start off with a little hula. It goes a little something like this. Maokoko. I am palm trees with the waterfall, and we'll pick some pineapples, little pineapples, put them in our basket, and that's a little it. Now I'll just do a little shimmy, just for all of you, and this one's for you, honey. All right.
Having three entertainers in one family.
It's a blessing. Kasi actually naman, boses ko, hindi maganda. Na actually, nagbana sila lahat sa tatay nila. Yung looks ko lang ang nakuha nila.
What made you want to leave Masbate?
Yung boxer ko, apat na laban ko sa Masbate, puro panalo. Ngayon, doon na ako nag-dream na hinangaan ko si Placid Lorde. Then ako nag-dream sa ako, wow, I want to be like Placid Lorde, world champion for 7 years.
Yes.
Tapos eh, doon na ako sinubukan ko ang buhay sa Manila.
What was going on in those years in Manila before leaving to go abroad?
Actually, I got 6 girlfriends. You know, when you're a boxer, Everybody
wants to be your girlfriend. I got it. When did you realize that you had the kind of talent that was suitable for a world champion? Tell me.
Lumalaban ako ng puro panalo. Siyempre, talagang magaling ka na. Gusto mo nang maging champion. Pero hindi ako nagkaroon ng chance na lumaban ng champion. Pero nung the biggest fight ko na nangyari doon sa Hawaii, yun doon yung last stopover ko ng lahat ng laban kasi na kita ako ng isang promoter sa LA nung lumaban ako sa forum. Ang kinalaban ko doon, world champion.
Who did you fight?
Si Ruben Olivares.
You fought Olivares at the forum?
Forum.
Okay, how did you do against him?
I lost the fight, but I, you know this one? Broken.
You broke that?
Yeah, his head, the first once I hit the head, boom, I said, oh my God, I cannot fight anymore.
You broke your hand
in the head.
In the first punch,
first punch.
On Olivares' head.
First round, yes.
Tell us how your boxing career ended.
Kumuha ko ng lisensya para sa 1970. Eh, hindi na ako nakapasa kasi meron daw na-diagnose na meron ako kidney trouble, kidney problem. Pero inano naman ako nila, tinignan naman ng doktor, 14 days ako sa ospital, wala naman ako nakitang something wrong, pero hindi pa rin ako bigyan ng license. Kaya medyo wala na ako ng pag-asa sa boxing. Kaya nawala na rin, bumagsak na rin ang pag-asa ko na patulungan na ang aming Pilipinas. Ang aking church na tinipromise ko na makatulong sa anak sa nila, hindi ko nila gawa. Kaya medyo naloko-loko dito, nasira ang buhay. Mabuti lang nun, yung asawa ko, yung asawa ko, maratal masyado. Lahat ng ginagawa ko masama, lagi akong pinapasinsya niya. That's why, wala nang mapapalit na sa asawa ko.
Give me three words that best describe Bernie.
Comical, matigas ang ulo, mapagmahal naman.
What was the nickname that Bernie was known by in the ring?
The clown, actually. Kasi clown siya ng clown sa ano.
How could you be a clown and be a rated contender for a championship? Aren't the boxers have names like the Tiger or the Killer or something like? How did he beat people after being a clown?
Kasi nalilito yung mga kalaban niya. Kasi minsan mababakla-bakla siya. Kunyari, sasabihin nila before the fight, you know, oh, I'll beat you. Oh, really? Yung mga pag-anon. Tapos pag nasa ring na sila, ang galaw niya, ikot ang ikot. Tapos yung mag-aali siya po, mga kung ano-ano. Tapos biglang igaganon yung isang kamay. Yung pala, yung isang susuntok niya. You know, kaya tawanan ng tawanan mga tao.
One of the things that I know my mom is really proud of is that my dad never laid a finger on her. He never did. I mean, you might have walls in the holes in the house, but he never laid a finger on her. And he taught to love her, to truly treat her as the lady of the house.
He loves to take care of his family, you know, just whatever he can do as much as he can give to us, whatever, even if it's his last dollar, he'll give me a dollar. He's like, oh, well, okay, here you go.
He puts his own family first, and I mean, the only reason why he wasn't able to go was because he was pretty much taking care of us, you know, and like, I promised I wasn't gonna do this. But I mean, he's a real good dad, and he deserves this, and his family. I know they miss him, but one of his brothers is like one of my favorite uncles, you know, Uncle Ibong. And when I went there, all they asked about was their brother. And, you know, he wasn't able to go because he had to take care of his finances on this side.
So all this time, Bernie, life is good in Hawaii. The family's all situated. Elena's working, you know, you're working on and off. And everybody's happy.
Yes.
And then you turn 50, and something happens. Something that threatens the very foundation of your family. What happened?
Naging addict ako, tapos naging dealer ako ng sabok.
Coming up, life gets serious for this clown.
Bacteria overcome the good bacteria in your body. This is an emergency. Lactovitale saves the day. Armed with live lactobacilli, vitamins and minerals, and good health in a bottle, Lactovitale reinforces the good bacteria to extinguish the bad. Save your health. Drink Lactovitale and experience good health in a bottle.
Siguro nga pinaglayo na tayo ng tadhana dahil sa sobrang sakit ang mga naganap sa ating dalawa. Pero ito tayo ngayon. Ano ibig sabihin nito?
Ano ibig sabihin? Hindi tayo magkakahiwalay.
Aba, happy together na naman sila! Kaya si Errol, busted!
Paano mo sasabihin sa daddy mo ngayon na nagbago na naman ang isip mo? Na ayaw mo na naman bumalik ng Barcelona?
Mom, Dad, may kasama po kami.
Good afternoon po.
Crazy for you!
Laking ginawa ng pamilya ko. Salamat sa Star Cargo.
Negosyo na madaling patakbuhin, suportado pa ng ABS-CBN. Yan ang Star Cargo. Be an agent in your community and earn a better life for your family. Call Star Cargo now.
Drug dealing is a serious offense in the United States, carrying only the stiffest penalties. In most states, it's punishable by a term of incarceration in the state prison. At the age of 50, Bernie found himself dealing in methamphetamine, commonly known to most Pinoys as shabu. Bernie, you were 50 years old. Why drugs, and why at that point in your life?
Well, wala kang magagawa. Sometimes, na di ka walang perfect sa tao. Nung napasama ka sa wrong crowd, you got it.
Were you a drinker too, or?
Oh, yes.
So,
drink, drugs, marijuana, all kind of drugs, I tried it all.
Now, Tita, did you see it coming? Did you see this behavior coming on, and did you know that he was addicted to shabu?
No, I didn't even know he was addicted to shabu, because it's always mad at people who were on drugs. You know, what do you guys get, you know, out of drugs and this kind of thing? And it's always, palagi niyang pinagsasabihan yung mga taong nasa drugs. Para tumigil, wala ko. Tapos bigla naman, nagulat ako.
Bernie, how did you hide it from your family and your wife? How did you do that?
Hindi ako nasira na hindi na magtatrabaho. Dahil nasa drugs ako, trabaho pa rin, trabaho. Walang hinto, walang ano. Kaya saka hindi ko ginagamit yung pera ko pagbili ng drugs. Mm-hmm. Kaya nga napilitan akong binta rin kasi kailangan kong suportahan yung habit ko.
What was your habit? How much were you using on a daily basis?
No limit.
How did it affect your relationship with your wife?
Nung first time, okay lang kasi hindi niya alam. Pero nung nasamahan ko na ng babae, doon na. Tapos doon na nasira, lalo na nung nahuli na ako.
Elena, that must have been a tough time for you. Did you finally get fed up?
Oh, yeah. Kasi lumalaki na yung anak ko. Medyo nakikita na nila yung away-away namin. Kaya ko yung nakikita ng mga anak ko yung... yung away-away namin yun. Matagal ko na siyang gusto. Wala yan. Naawa ko sa mga anak. Kasi ayoko lumaki yung mga anak ko na walang tatay. Tapos nakikita nila yung tatay nila ganun. Kaya nagsasakripisyo na lang ako na hindi ko na lang intindihin.
So how did it finally end?
Nahuli siya. Wala na, ayaw ko makita ng mga anak ko niya. Gaganon siya. Kasi nung nahuli siya, napakasakit. Pati yung mga anak ko nadamay.
Can you think of any explanation for it? I mean, you know, your life is somewhat different now because of the fact that you've got all your family with you now, but could this ever happen again, you think?
No. Not at all. I mean, wala talaga, hindi na mangyayari yan kasi I tried it and I don't want it to happen again.
Elena, did you go to the trial? Were you there to support him? And were you acting as a supportive wife at that time?
Wala na. Wala na kasi kami nun. Galit na galit ako nun kasi I found out na mayroon siyang babae. Ayoko na makita siya. So galit na galit ako talaga nun.
Well, Elena, when you kicked him out, did you ever think you were going to see him again?
No. Hindi na kasi nandun na siya. Kasama na siya nung umuwi na siya sa babae niya. Tapos naririnig ko, nakipagkaibigan pa ako sa babae para walang gulo.
Mm-hmm.
Para hindi malagay sa alangan ng mga anak ko.
Did you ever think, this is it, I screwed it up?
I know. No. Oh, yes, I think of that how many times. She's not gonna love me again. I mean, never, I don't think so. But I never give up.
Hmm?
I never give up until she accept me back. But with the help of my mga anak ko.
Mm-hmm.
Kung di sa anak ko, ito, ayaw ko kung tatanggapin pa ako niya.
Mm-hmm.
Di na siguro.
Any words of wisdom that maybe something you may have learned from this?
I advise them, don't even try. The drugs is no good for you or anybody else.
Now, just to change topics for a second, when was the last time you were back in Masbate?
And since I left, I never been back.
And your mom and dad were alive at the time you left, correct?
Yes, very much alive.
Now, when you, they passed away, both of them passed away, and were you able to go back for the funeral, or were you able to speak to them before they passed, or anything like that?
Gusto ko mabalik, pero wala akong magagawa nung araw na yun, nung palaw na yun eh. Wala kami pera. Pahirap ang buhay namin noon, wala akong trabaho. Gusto ko makita ang lalay ko kasi mahal ko yung lalay ko, siya lang pinigil sa akin ng buhay. Every time I remember her, I talagang hindi ko mapigilan umiyak. Namatay ang tatay ko, hindi lang ako nabalik. Namatay ang kapatid ko. Dalawang kapatid ko. Ang kapatid kong babae. Tatlong lalaki. Hindi ako nakabalik. Sana kung dito ako sa Hawaii, abang sa last day, kasi siguro nakabalik ako kasi marami naman makakatulong dito sa gandang babae dito ng kunti. Ay, sa Hawaii, mahirap ang buhay. Lalo na noon, 1975. Wala akong trabaho noon eh.
I get a chance to talk to you and get to know you and find out the reasons why you want to go back to the Philippines. And you have been very clear about your reasons to go back. You've got to see your family. It's been a long time since you've been there. It's a long time coming. I know that there was a promise that you made a long time ago. That when you came back, you would help out and rebuild the church. We're hoping that that's something you still might be able to do. But in the meantime, we hope, the folks at Pinagmulan, and of course, courtesy of Cathay Pacific, we'd like to send you back to the Philippines, courtesy of Cathay Pacific.
Oh my God! So, thank you. Oh man.
So pack your bags, get that Balikbayan box ready.
Thank you.
And
oh my God, look at me.
What do you think, man? Are you looking forward to it?
Of course. Thank you.
Drug use and drug dealing and a prison sentence, all in the middle of this thing. The adversity that he's got to overcome, the obstacles that are in the way, and still he has this burning desire to go home. There's got to be something about going home and about being there that is important. And it's something that we like to capture on the show. And I, Lord knows that Bernie is passionate about this. He's touched a lot of people's hearts. He's touched us, clearly. I'm just so looking forward to be with him on this important trip of his. Coming up, Bernie puts on his cowboy hat and whips it good.
When the bad bacteria overcome the good bacteria in your body, this is an emergency. Lactobacillus saves the day, armed with live lactobacilli, vitamins and minerals, and good health in a bottle. Lactobacillus reinforces the good bacteria to extinguish the bad. Save your health. Drink Lactobacillus and experience good health in a bottle.
A house inspired by a sailboat? So is it a house or a boat?
Wow, when did you build this?
Find out what it is while we rock the boat on Urban Zone.
Discovery Suites. It's more than just a hotel.
Welcome to my world.
Next on World Musikahan with Brian Kayabyab. Buhay America takes center stage when Bernardo, Pedro Reyes, and Jet Montelibano. Sing songs about living the American dream on World Musikahan with Ryan Gabyab on TFC.
Laking ginawa ng pamilya ko. Salamat sa Star Cargo.
Negosyo na madaling patakbuhin, suportado pa ng ABS-CBN. Yan ang Star Cargo. Be an agent in your community and earn a better life for your family. Call Star Cargo now.
Bernie's journey has taken us to the center of the Philippine archipelago. This is the gateway to southern Luzon and the Visayas. Welcome to the green and serene island of Masbate. Masbate is situated offshore mainland Bicol, just north of the Visayas. It consists of three major islands, Masbate, Tikal, and Burias. Smack dab in the middle of the country, the province is a melting pot of cultures, dialects including Masbateño, Bicolano, Waray, Cebuano, Ilonggo, Capiseño, and Visayan. There's plenty of ongoing construction and development to attract more tourists, but most of Masbate remains unspoiled, with still large expanses of tropical forests and pristine beaches. These days, Masbate is known for its cattle raising and is proud to be the rodeo capital of the Philippines. So saddle up for a Wild West adventure, Masbate style. Immediately after landing at Masbate Airport, Bernie and Elena are greeted by the Lapai Bantige Children's Dance Group. They have prepared their new dance especially for Bernie. It tells the story of how a local bird leaves the nest, then eventually finds its way back home. A fitting gesture for Bernie as they proudly welcome the return of their fellow Masbateño. Excited what to see and do in Masbate these days. They don't call Masbate the rodeo capital of the Philippines for nothing. So we're going to check out some of the action at Co Ranch. Ranch hands commonly use bull whips to lead their cattle. With the right force and swing, the end of the whip makes a loud crack in the air. Bull whipping contests are part of rodeo festivals. Competitors show off their dance-like movements while continuously cracking their whips for 3 minutes. Bernie and I grab hold of the bullwhip and take a crack at it. This actually felt like a practical lesson in physics. Call me a natural, I actually got that bullwhip cracking in no time at all. Bernie tried and tried, but only managed to lose his hat several times and crack us up with his usual antics. Next, our friends taught us how to throw a proper lasso. Knowing how to throw a lasso is essential for any ranch hand, and it certainly comes in handy when catching that wayward cow. Throwing that noose is trickier than I thought, but with some practice and a little luck, I managed to bust me a bronco. Bernie needed more time to learn the ropes, in a manner of speaking. After several unsuccessful attempts, Bernie decided to run after the cattle, quite literally, and try to take the bull by the horns. But his asthma got the better of him and he had to give up. Nice try, big guy. The last activity proved to be the ultimate challenge. Now, I've wrestled with many things in my life, but wrestling a cow, it's easier than you think. At least, that's what Leo tells me. He explained the procedure to me, and without so much as a practice round, I gave it my best shot right away.
All one needs to do is lift the cow's muzzle or mouth and push it backwards. This actually renders the cow helpless. A little push and the cow falls to the ground. Take that, Batista.
Yeah, that was nice. One more.
Coming up, Bernie jumps ship for his big Masbate homecoming.
Mag-iikot-ikot pa tayo sa nag-iisang trip na trip!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5!
Rig noon, sikat na mga tugtugin ulit ngayon with Hot Dogs Rene Garcia. Kasama ang singing champions, Jen.
Na ako nahalikan.
Rachel.
An album together that idol
could be
number one, number one.
This Pinagmulan reunion is brought to you by Lactobacillus Lactobacillus Health Drink. We bring good health into your home. This is Bernie's humble hometown of Nabangig. It's a tiny fishing village that hasn't changed much since Bernie left. To this day, the people of Nabangig live the simple life, getting their sustenance and earning their livelihood from the sea. Bernie's about to be reunited with his family in his hometown. But here's the fun part. He's managed to keep it a secret from his family members. We've told him that we're a United States sports program and that we've come here to interview his family to get some information about him. But in reality, he's on a boat with Elena. They're gonna come offshore and surprise everybody. Many of Bernie's relatives that morning, including three of Bernie's brothers, Max, Ebong, and Dodong.
Hey, how's it, Mike? How are you doing?
Good, good.
Can I talk to anybody in there?
Here, hold on.
Hello? Manoy?
Ay, tuloy-tuloy.
Si Bernito, kapatid mo.
Wow naman. Parang iiyak na ko niyan eh. Kanina, iyak na ako eh. Ito si Ibong.
Dandal eh. Dandal na po to.
Eh?
Wala na?
Pero wala, hindi na ano to.
Hello?
Hello.
This is Bernie?
Mm.
You got one more, here.
Yes, yes.
Hello?
Hello?
Inudoy?
Hello? Sino to?
Inibong.
Ay! Hello, kumusta rin dyan?
Sabi mo, saya. Masaya. Kaya lang, masaya nga eh. Ikaw naman, ikaw lang iniintay namin eh. Kala namin, ikaw nang uwi eh.
Hindi nga eh.
Kala namin eh, kung ito nang uwi kasi surpresa sa amin, surpresa mo sa amin.
Malapit na kayo masurpresa.
As fast as his feet could carry him, Bernie came closer to where his family had gathered. He kept talking to his brothers, who remained unaware of the fact that Bernie is literally just around the bend. Soon enough, he came face to face with a family he's been away from for 41 years. Maybe it was shock or simply the long years of separation, but it took a few seconds before Bernie's brothers recognized the man standing before them. Once they realized it was indeed Bernie, there was no stopping their tears of joy.
Only for 1 year, that's all. Like, when I take on one news. Wow. Siloto. Siloto. Mama. Mama, busy. Mama, sorry, Siloto. Siloto. Wow. Oh, Mama, ikaw lang ang nandito. Sino itong kapon to? Sino? Oh my God. Parang si Manoy nung bata pa eh. Gano'n pa rin. O sige. Susunod sa akin ha.
Bernie, I bet you're wondering why we brought you here with all these people. We're going to be playing a game.
Uh-huh.
The name of the game is Sino Si Mrs. Now, how long have you been married?
37 years.
Okay, 37 years. Yes. Okay. What we're going to do in this game is we're going to put a blindfold on you. This blindfold right here.
Uh-huh.
And we're going to line up some women.
Uh-huh.
And oh my God. What your job is going to be is with this blindfold on, you're going to have to feel each one of them and tell me whether or not they're the person that is your wife of all these years. But it should be easy, right?
Okay.
Yeah, but we're going to put boxing gloves on you.
Oh.
Okay? And then afterwards, you don't have to say yes or no. You give them a kiss on the cheek.
Out.
Okay? Now, we're going to try to figure out if you can do this. And the idea of this game isn't so much to find out how well you know your wife.
Oh, my.
But it's to see how fast she can knock you out if you don't.
Oh, my God.
Are you ready?
We'll try.
Okay. Down, you can touch anywhere, but be a gentleman.
Ikaw ba?
You can go down.
Tapos na,
you got a kiss. You got a kiss on the cheek. The cheek, Bernie.
Hindi ko alam eh.
Well, wait.
One kiss. Okay. Contestant number two.
Ito na. Uy. Uy. Oh my God.
One kiss, man. One. Okay. Ready for the next one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Uy. Ah, ito na siguro. Sabi nila, limb to limb.
When you're ready to kiss, I'll do it.
Ah, lalaki to.
I can tell.
Okay. Next. No cheating.
Oh my God. Oh boy. Ben. Tulungan mo ako.
When you're ready, do the kiss.
Ah, hindi yan.
Okay, next.
Next.
Okay, we'll start with the shoulders.
Oh. Oh my God.
Kiss. Okay, what? There was five of them. Now, which one was it? Okay, now, step over here. Okay, one, two, three, four, five. Which one was it?
Wow, I don't know. I don't know. Can I do it again?
No! You cannot do it again.
One, two, three. I think this one over here, number three.
Number three?
One, two. No. Where is that now?
We started from here this side.
One, two, three, four, five. Jesus. One, two, three, four.
Five.
Never I think number four.
Yes, 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 yes,
yes.
That's
right. Yes,
yes, yes. Oh man, how did I know you?
Yes.
I know I feel something like this also. The first time when I do like no, when I do like this, I thought that was already, but then I said, oh my God, that's not the one.
Yes. Lift to lift. Good job. Hey, you know what? On behalf of the staff, you are the winner.
Coming up, the clown spreads a little sunshine. This Pinagmulan reunion is brought to you by Lactobacillus Lactobacillus Health Drink. We bring good health into your home.
Tired of those boring snacks? Introducing new Zap Snacks. Put a zesty zap into your snacks. Zap Dillies. Zap Pusit. Zap Rice Nuggets. Zap Mixed Fruit Chips. Put Zap into your life with Zap Snacks.
Zap Zarap.
Zap Snacks and Super Zarap.
Lunch?
I have an appointment.
Dinner?
Cat.
Who are you meeting up with anyway?
Someone very important.
Sa tingin ko, ayaw sa akin ni Tatot. Pero hindi ko sa inyo na ako nakilala. Yaling, baka naman tinaguntungan sa atin.
Again?
Tatot, ano ba yan? Gabi-gabi na. Tatot.
Panalo kayo sa LBC. Magpadala ng balikbayan box at may libre kayong air pouch mula sa LBC. Mas maraming padalang regalo, mas masayang Pasko. Magpadala na sa LBC.
We laugh. Thank you.
understand you. And it's all because we listen.
The church in Nabangi. When Bernie left, he made a panata, or promise, that he would help this church out as soon as he became rich or famous. 41 years later, he'd be the first one to admit to you that he's neither wealthy nor famous, but he still somehow wants to help carry out that promise.
Ang panata ko ay paglaki ko naging champion, papagawa ko ng simbahan. So kung maganda, kahit maliit, basta maganda. Pero hindi ako na naging champion.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi rin ako naging mayaman, kaya wala akong magawa.
Does it look any different than it did before?
Nang araw talagang medyo hindi makilala. Parang hindi simbahan.
Yeah.
Ngayon mas maganda naman. At least, naayos.
After a short but sincere prayer, Bernie, with the help of his wife, brothers, and Goy Luck's Bake Shop, put some smiles on the faces of the many residents of Nabangi. Journey Home would like to thank the following special friends: Cathay Pacific, Airline of the Year 2006, and the international carrier for Pinagmulan. Goldilocks Bake Shop, how thoughtful, how Pinoy. Discovery Suites at Ortigas Center, more than just a hotel. Andok's Lechon Manok, ang pammansang manok. Lacto Vital, Lactobacillus Health Drink, we bring good health into your home. Timex Foods, makers of Zap. Sea Air, the fastest way to Boracay, the most flights to Palawan.
Subic Holiday Villas, Governor Antonio Co of Masbate, Co Nature Resort, Kokak Beach Resort, Backdoor Adventures, Co Ranch, Rodeo Masbateño, Tourism Office of Masbate.
What does it take to finally come home again? This is your Pinagmulan, and we urge you to take that journey.
Write to us and tell us why you haven't been back to the Philippines in years, but now feel the need to make that trip back home. Email us at Pinagmulan@abs-cbni.com or send your life story to Pinagmulan, The Journey Home, ABS-CBN International, 150 Shoreline Drive, Redwood Shores, California, 94065.
Instant pa premyo, instant panalo sa LBC. Each time you send money with LBC, you get a chance to win cash, gift checks worth thousands of dollars, or free padalas to the Philippines instantly. So come to LBC now and win.
Meet Princess, rich girl na tanging wish ay happiness. Makakamit kaya niya ito sa tulong ng isang magical switch? Angelica Panganiba
sa Love Spell presents
Home Switch Home.
Mga kababayan, pagkakataon nyo lang mapanood ang paborito nyong Pinoy ng ABS-CBN TFC Direct. Just contact the following authorized dealers para maipaliwanag sa inyo everything you need to know about our 6-channel bundle.
journey home included a trip to Facenda de Esperanza, a drug rehabilitation center. He was able to commune with some of the residents and leave them with some inspiring words. Sage advice for a person who suffered through the darkest days of his life, yet still came out alive and hopeful. When Bernie left Masbate, he was a young man. A man full of promise, a man that was ready to take on the world. He's going to be a bantamweight champion. He had the talent, he had the desire, and he left and he went to Manila. 41 years later, after making a promise to fix his church, he comes back. But he doesn't come back to the Masbate he remembers. He comes back to a totally different place. But what hasn't changed? What hasn't changed is his love for his family, his brother's love for him, and the fact that he wanted to come back and try to give something back to his community. But the important thing about Bernie is that he never forgot who he was, and he never forgot where he was from.
Madalang mong pamilya mo, madalang mong mga kapatid mo, kasi ito mapapakita ko sa mga anak ko. Makikita nila ang buong Masbate at Pilipinas para masabing yan ang roots ng aking ema at ina.
Nung dumating kami sa airport, di ako makapaniwala. Paiyak ako kasi may mga bata nagsayaw sa halap namin. Habang kami naglalakad, nakita ko ang aking mga kapatid, ang sangkatuta kong kapatid. Napakasarap ng pakiramdam. Di ako makapaniwala na ganun pala ang pakiramdam ng tao pag nakita mo uli ang iyong mga pamilya. Kaya napakaligaya ko. Lahat ang nangyari dito sa Masbate na di ko makapaniwala na magagawa ko. Kumain pa ako ng dilis, sarap-sarap yung hilaw, yung bagong kakukuha lang sa, ano, sa dagat. Nakuhang sarap-sarap. Kahit si Mike, kumain din ng dilis na hilaw. Kaya, ang sarap-sarap ng buhay ng makauwi ka sa Pilipinas.
And sooner than he had wanted, it was time to say farewell to Manoy and the rest of the Fernandez clan. The last reunion came with a promise to someday, soon, come back to Masbate and once again share the love with those who are and forever will be family to Bernie. This has been Bernie's journey home. From Masbate, this is Mike Ingona, urging you to take that journey home and rediscover your Pinagmulan.
Saan ako napunta? Liguling ang daan, pinanggalingan ko'y nasaan? Ako'y hirap ng lumain. Ako ngayon ay
Pinagmulan, the best. I love you.
Pinagmulan, the journey home was brought to you by Cathay Pacific. Now you're really flying. Zap Snacks. Super zarap ang Zap.
And by Goldilocks. How thoughtful. How Pinoy.